exile to be. Fairies will not veil you if you will die. That color does not fit this group. Nor will you wear on your cover a shining purple. Wait. I said purple, didn't I? Oh, fuck. Shining violet? No. Lavender. Peony? Chrysanthemum, okay. How the fuck do you spell chrysanthemum? C-H-R-Y... Fuck. I need another drink.
Jeez.
Not that I've had a decent fucking drink since they sent me out from Rome. Water this shit down.
Hey there, dollface. Come here often.
Oh, I've really lost it now.
Well, I never had much faith in your sanity.
I'm seeing things. Apparitions.
No, I assure you I am very much real.
Or am I dreaming?
As flattering as it is that you dream of me.
No, but sleep is respite from cares. It would be cruel indeed to have Amor haunting my dreams. Amor.
Or Cupid. Eros. Love personified.
I'd recognize that god anywhere. There's no one better known to me.
You didn't come here just to flirt with me.
How could I not recognize the cause of my exile? You appeared to me before, you guided me when I was just a young poet. You told me not to write epic, not to write of great heroes.
I maintain that was a smart career choice. After all, who needs another Iliad ripoff?
Maybe my genius wasn't great, but it was something! And you diminished it by telling me to write about you and your mother's domain.
Okay, would you just listen?
Well, what did my love poems give me? Exile. Exile in this icy prison at the edge of the goddamn fucking world! Exile! Look at this nightmare you've caused. Even death would be better.
Would you snap out of it?
Oh, you're really here?
Yes, you idiot. I'm here and I refuse to be blamed for your exile. I came here because you're so pathetic, wallowing in your misery and pickling yourself in this bar. In case you don't remember, you used to be a great poet.
Of course I remember.
And you were great when you sang about love. What are you writing now?
Sad things.
Right. And how's that gonna help you? Why don't we, just a thought, maybe, for tonight, put away the sad things. In case you haven't noticed, love is here.
This place is not suitable for love.
In fact, what are you to differ? I've been around here, you know, Cocos. It's just a quick trip from here. Well, if you have wings. I was on a little errand for my mother. She wanted that Colchian girl, Medea, and then for the sickness.
That isn't a sad story. It's literally a tragedy.
No, it's epic. At least your version was. And you know who the star was?
Jason.
Absolutely not. Me. Love.
What? No,
unless I'm remembering the story wrong. Oh, if only there was someone here. Some poet. Who could tell him to set the record straight?
If only.
Oh, pretty please, won't you? Just one little story in the name of love.
Fine. One story, then you leave me alone. Now the Argonauts were cutting the channel with their ship. After they had endured many things under the guidance of illustrious Jason. And finally, they reached the rapid waves of muddy Phasis. They approached the king and asked for a fleece of Phrixus, and a horrendous condition of great labors is given to the Argonauts. Meanwhile, the daughter of the king, Medea, fosters strong fires. And after struggling for a long time, she was not able to conquer her fury with reason. And then, she says,
just leaving him dead, I don't see Burns to the ground, so the god fell into flames. His entire chest burned, and he fed sterile love with hope. For, at once, Daphne fled even the name love.
shore and what the Daphne do to you. And let us remember what you said. Love is everyone's greatest desire. No, Daphne didn't want anything to do with you. And yet, love made her a fucking tree.
Well, I don't think it's fair to only have this story heard. It's not the first time it happened. Love turned people into trees. Come on, you know it. Tell the good people. On the hills of...
No, I said no more.
Well, then I don't need your help. On the hills of Phrygia, there's a lime tree next to me. Not far from there is stagnant land, full of gulls and swamp birds. But once it was a habitable land. And to this place, Jupiter came, dressed as a mortal, of course. And with him came his son, Mercury. They were doing the classic gods check on the morality of the mortals someday. And on their way, they visited 1,000 houses seeking shelter. And one by one, 1,000 houses quietly assured their peace. But one remained.
It's small indeed it is, and sure our roof is made of sticks and reeds from the swamp. But dear Box and I moved here when we were in our younger years. Do come in. Mind your heads. You can sit here and rest a bit. We'll own up to our poverty. It doesn't make us uneasy. But Box and I moved. This makes us uneasy. There are no masters or servants of the house. Bacchus and I are the full household, so we'll both rule or serve, whatever you like. Bacchus, dear.
Oh, Philemon, our visitors can't sit here. Let me put a blanket down, sirs. The bench is so rough. Oh, then I'll get a fire going. There's nothing but yesterday's ashes in the hearth. Oh, and Philemon, give me that cabbage. I'll take the leaves off the outside.
It's from our garden, and well watered the last few weeks. Then why don't I see if we don't have a bit of bacon left to cook up for you?
Are you comfortable there? We might take our couch out while you wait. It's made of willow and we have a drapery for it. Excuse me. Though, we usually take it out for holidays and it is old and cheap. But it does suit the wood well. At least, let me give you some water to warm yourselves. Oh, let me help you. Watch your hand. Oh, no. Might as well. Thank you so much.
Marcus, why don't you see if there's honey left, and maybe some fruit and nuts. I'll clear this, and we'll set another course. We have a goose, too, and we'd serve it to you, of course, if only we could catch it. And why don't I see if we don't have a bit of wine left, if you're finished with it.
The pantry! It's still full!
Who did you guys say that you were again?
We didn't. Do not trouble yourselves, and do not kill the goose. We are... goths. Traveling in your neighborhood, we were turned away from every house. They will be punished as they deserve. But you... you will be... go now and look at the countryside around.
Everything's covered in water. It's a swamp. This is the only house remaining.
And look around you.
The beams that turn the columns and the straw with the gold and, well, the carved floor and the carved doors are now covered in marble. You're humble with those.
Is that a temple?
And now ask of us your trouble. Anything you wish.
Because we have spent our years together, let the same hour carry us both away from life. So that I never have to see the tomb of my wife, and that I may never be buried by her.
Give you what you ask. And I will tell you, after many long years of living, when you're standing before this very temple speaking of things past, Bacchus, you will see Philemon begin to grow leaves, and Philemon, you will see Bacchus. And as the branches grow over both of your faces, you will still have time to say, farewell, my love, before the trunk closes both of your lips at once.
Centuries, passers-by will see two trees, close together, twins, growing as if from one body.
I don't think you can reasonably take credit for that happy ending. No, that metamorphosis was Jupiter's doing, because Bacchus and Philemon were virtuous and good. There was no little arrow shooting cherub in the back of this one.
Please, were you even listening to the story? On the hills So then what is your problem? Do you really think love wasn't in that story? That house, those trends?
You think that this is your domain? You, who concerns yourself with pursuit and desire and
sex. Excusez moi! Isn't it the only things I concern myself with?
What else do you do then?
Okay, so you're not entirely incorrect. When my arrow first wounds you, there's the burning pain of the wall. But you see, wounds heal eventually, and the love remains.
But you only make the wound? You can't take credit for what happens after it heals.
My arrow strikes much deeper than the serpent's. No one's left unchanged.
So you want me to expect to believe that that is the explanation for Bacchus and Philemon? That you made them loyal and pious and good?
Well, I can't reasonably say I made them good, but I can say I helped. I made them content with nothing but each other.
I still don't see—
What did I say love was? A painful longing. The longing is still there. They never wanted to be apart from one another. But in mutual love, companionship, the pain is gone. You're not such a stranger to this yourself. There we go. Though everything overwhelms me, you still conquer my mind. You hold a greater part of my heart than any—
Where did you get that? That's private.
I told you, all aspects of love are my domain.
Give it back!
Which includes love letters. I speak to you although absent. My voice names you only. Without you, no night comes for me, no day. They tell me that when sick and unable to speak, your name appears in my senseless mouth. If I should now fail, and my tongue affix itself to the roof of my mouth, scarcely able to be revived by dropping in wine. This is an oddly specific image right now. If someone should announce that my lady has come, I would get up again, and the hope of seeing you would be the cause of my strength.
What right do you have to read my letters to my wife?
Let this be a lesson to you not to argue with the divinity. And let this be a lesson to the rest of you. Straight from the horse's mouth, there is more to love than sex.
Fine. You still got it slightly wrong. Mutual love does not always mean the end of pain.
Oh, dear, I'm sorry for reminding you that you're so far from—
No, not me. But you have to admit that just because two people love each other doesn't mean that being together is simple and painless. Poetry has always been filled with stories of forbidden love. Seeing as you're so keen on stories tonight, let me tell you one.
Okay.
This is a story about a wedding that happened a long time ago on an island called Crete.
To the most beautiful, most praiseworthy woman in all of Crete. Age and beauty are equal between you, and you grew up together. You learned your lessons in the same place, shared the same experiences, and wild love touched both your hearts. There's an equal one in each of them. Why do you despair?
Yanfei looks forward to her wedding with a man. She trusts that I am a man. I love her, but how will she delight in me? As if I'm burning.
My child, years ago when you were about to be born, your father told me that should you be born as a girl, you must be put to death. He said that girls are more burdensome, that they do not have strength, and we were poor, but that night that you were born, I had a vision. The goddess told me to protect my child no matter what they were. I woke up, my pains increased, and I gave birth, and I bade the nurses feed the boy. You, this act was in good faith.
But what annoys me now? My anxieties are known by none, my love would be called freakish. Crete is a land of cunning tricks, but if Delos himself flew here on wax wings, what would it do? Would he make a boy from a maiden with learned skill?
If it's collect yourself.
I should throw out useless plans and foolish desires. I should see what I was born as, or I to see myself as well. I should seek what is allowed, moral, lawful, and live as I, a woman, ought to. Oh, this season, you find hope in cherishing love, but reality will steal it from you.
There is no barrier, no guard keeps you from her embrace, nor some watchful other man, nor the expectations of her father. She herself does not deny herself to you. All these things are
true. But I cannot be with her! I cannot be happy if both gods and men would wish for me to be. I want what our families want. My nature forbids it. Nature alone harms me, but is more powerful than anything. The longed for time is here, and I cannot. I will be dying of thirst in the middle of the sea. There can be no wedding!
Guys, I pray Varus and you comfort our fears. You, goddess, I once saw clearly and recognized, and I remember your unforgettable commands. Because of you, my child sees this day, and I am not made to suffer. These gifts and guidance are yours, so please, pity us and help us. Shame to rejoice.
So, in the end, it worked out?
In the end. It has got to pay for you to be on the end.
So, love is a good thing.
No. No, love still caused pain.
But then I resolved it.
Well, sort of. Indirectly. But I mean, Ivis's life would have been so much easier if they never fallen in love.
Would it?
I don't know, you tell me. Could it be such a good thing that people would gladly suffer for love? Would die for it?
You're asking me? I may be a little biased.
But there's so much in the way. Death, distance, laws, Augustus, a fucking law. Anything can keep people apart. Love is more likely to end in tragedy, don't you see?
Well, who doesn't love a good tragedy?
Well, sure. Love makes a good story.
Now we're getting somewhere.
What?
Look, okay. Forget whether or not love is good or bad or powerful or whatever.
No, I am good.
As much as I hate to admit this, this whole thing isn't about me.
It's not?
No, silly. It's about poetry. But her love makes us stories you can't ever forget.
Well, there was always one story that I thought was...
Yes?
Well, it had everything. Young, beautiful lovers. Ancient grudge between families.
Check.
Untimely deaths.
No! You have my attention! Now hit me with your best shot!
thou, Pyramus. Deny your father and refuse your name. If you will not, be but sworn, my love, and let me no longer be my father's daughter.
Oh, you envious wall. Why do you stand between the lovers? How much does it cost for you to allow us to be drawn together?
Nothing but your name is my enemy. What's in a name? Will we call a rose if it smell as sweet under any other name?
So would Pyramus. If she were not Pyramus called, retain that dear perfection.
Oh, Pyramus, throw off your name and your family.
And if it is too much ask, at least open up for our kisses to pass through. But when not ungrateful, we know that thanks to you, the password was given for our words to pass between the lover's ears.
This envious wall and our family stand between us. But the love, they could not forbid.
The more they tried to gower up the fire, the more enraged. Amen. fear that something evil has fallen to my dear Tiffy. Wait. What is this? This is my fault. Since I felt her right before you.
Tall as a tree. Please lend me your sweetheart. Taryn, don't you dare flee. For how could you not be enamored by me?
Have you seen me? This baby? Ridiculous!
Oh, yeah, let's take a won't you give us a try? I swear, there is no other man quite like I. I am like the brightest stars in the sky. Like me, the sun sees the earth through one eye.
What? Yeah, what?
But yeah, let's take it. You resemble a cow?
What?
You're prouder than a peacock. Stubborn art thou, allegiance to a man I won't soon allow. Unless he's me, then I say let's make a vow. I do.
I do not.
I do. Oh, Galatea, you're the girl I dream of. As sweet as apples grown on branches above. Your loveliness and mine, they fit like a glove. So let us get married and we'll call it love. But yeah, let's take it, you're just like a squished snake. As ruthless as a river, large as a lake. As cunning as a cactus pricked by mistake. Call me your husband or my heart will break. Oh yeah, let's take an end to my strife. Submit yourself to me, I'll make you my wife. My eye is like a shield to my robust knife. I promise you that I am larger than life.
Who the hell is this? No. I think I deserve to know.
You? When did you get here?
Been here the entire time. Might want to get your eyes.
Sorry, eyes.
You know what? I would be more patient with this contempt if you fled everyone. But why? Having rejected me. What you love of Atkins?
Hey.
I do wish he would not please you. Give me the opportunity, and I will show you that my strength matches the size of my body. And I will drag out your organs while you're still alive and scatter your disembodied limbs over the sea. I burn for you! The flame burns even brighter now that I'm wounded. I feel like I'm carrying all the violence of a volcano in my chest. But you don't care. I will make sure that this is the last time you have this sort of meeting!
You need to go now.
What is he doing?
Nothing good now. Let's go!
Looks like he's up the volcano. Oh, he's trying to tear off a boulder or something. Oh yeah, he thinks he looks so cool. Lifting a boulder. Hey, your toxic masculinity isn't going to impress anyone.
I like Galatea. Oh, he's throwing it this way.
Oh shit, oh, he's ready.
Time, the bright red began to fade, and soon it was completely clear.
Polyphemus threw cracked open, and the hollow sounded with rushing waters, and then suddenly a man standing there right in the middle, with new horns growing on his head. And except for that, well, the fact that he was taller, his face was blue. It was Macus, the same Macus turned into a river god.
Great! Another happy ending.
It was a happy ending. Do you think I'd still be serving drinks to miserable people in this miserable place? No, Buzz. But you're the same as me, aren't you?
What do you mean?
Defeated? Betrayed by love? Well, the tale of a sea nymph getting dumped by the sea god she saved is a little too cliche for me to bother telling. Well, enough of my wasted youth. I'll leave you two kids to it.
I'm literally older than her.
Maybe stop acting like a child.
So you knew that story?
Knew it? I wrote it. Well, a version of it. The best version.
Why do you write about love so much?
I mean, who doesn't?
Well, yeah, everyone does, but like, you do it exceedingly. You have 15 books of epic. Everyone else would have certainly filled them with battles and wars and conflicts and strife and... Well, you get my point.
In no offense, animals must not speak very poor mascots.
Huh? Why are you speaking gibberish all of a sudden?
Do you not speak Latin?
Or it's a dead language?
My mind is turned to tell of bodies changed into new forms. I wanted to write about everything. Changes of seasons, flowing of rivers, flowers blooming and dying, the goddamn origin of the universe. And yes, love, well, you, but not you. Maybe this magic has something to do with love, but my poem is not about love.
But it is.
I know it appears that way. It's got all the love stories in it, but...
No, that's not what I mean. This poem is your love story. You are in love with poetry.
I didn't think a god could get drunk out of their mind.
But don't you get it? Your poems are an expression of your love.
I guess.
And you know what? You are so lucky! You have so much love, and you get to express it and be loved for it! If you were so obsessed with your own tragedy, you'd be able to see that.
Lucky? Are you serious?
Yes! Lucky. Look at all you wrote! You've gotten to speak so much about what you love. You know how few people get that chance? How lucky you are to have a voice? Well, I mean, usually. Here, sit down. Let me show you what I mean.
Look out!
Look out!
Look out!
Look out!
Is anyone here?
Here.
Come!
Come.
Flee me, but why?
Why?
Come. Let us meet here together.
Together?
Yes, together!
Together.
Withdraw your hands from me! I'm tired of those fair fools like you.
You. May he himself love, and may he not gain what he loves.
Have you ever witnessed anyone who is loved more cruelly than I? You've been a convenient spot for so many lovers. In such a long time, do you recall anyone who was wasted away like I do? I see what is pleasing me. What is pleasing in what I see? Reach out my arms. You reach out to me. When I laugh, you laugh! Oftentimes I saw your tears while I cried. I am this man that I see! I am burning in love for myself! Oh, what should I do? What I desire is with me already! Oh, how I wish I could depart my body. You know, I make a strange prayer for a lover. I wish what I love would disappear. And now, the pain has diminished my strength. There's not a long time left in my life. I will vanish. Death is nothing to me. Because at least death would remove all my pain. I wish he was loved. We'll live longer. Now we too shall die together. Farewell.
Thank you.
because I get to speak, to express my love of poetry.
And how self-obsessed you are! You don't even see the people who love you.
So what, Narcissus? Is that it?
You're acting like it! Look at Echo, how she...
How am I different from Echo? Here I am, saying words that I've already said to people who aren't listening. Did you really think those old stories would make them love me here? To make me someone worthy of being remembered again?
That's a little dramatic. You haven't been cursed.
Haven't I?
Look.
You look! I'm sorry. It just hurts too much. I know you're trying to help, but I can't. I'm done.
Any of you got any ideas? Because I am absolutely, completely an all-powerful god, and I know exactly what to do! Love you, dears! Thanks for the help! Times like these, you just have to phone a friend. Don't miss me while I'm gone!
What did I do wrong? Know how I edit this poem? Now my work here is done, which neither the wrath of Jupiter, nor fire, nor sword, nor the decaying force of time will be able to undo. In my better part, I will be carried above the lofty stones. Immortal, my name, undying. Is this punishment then? For daring to claim to be immortal? Well, look at me. The lofty stars, just a bar filled with strangers. No one to even know my undying name.
You're Ovid, right?
Holy shit. You know me. I mean, do I know you?
You can say that.
Who are you?
A colleague of yours. A poet, one might say.
Do any good?
Oh, I don't
can't be much of a poet, then.
I'm a love poet.
That's a terrible career choice. Trust me.
I heard there's been quite a bit of a show in here today.
Did you like it? Show
me. That I sing a song of my own?
Go ahead.
In my ears. You won't.
There's a poet of life. Well,
maybe I have a chance.
Ears wide and listen, hear well, with your tender hearts, for the tale I will tell. To others, to mice, is run parallel. Come witness how to God's divine virtue fell.
Morality versus...
words sung by Orpheus? How are you here? Also, nice cross.
Your dearest friend summoned me.
My
Amor, what the fuck?
You're
disturbing my peace wasn't enough. You're waking the dead now?
Oh, I stop at nothing for you, darling.
Oh, you don't have to stop for me. Continue.
I'm not gonna say it twice.
Asshole.
song.
Yours. Which one?
Tell us your story. I think it deserves to be remembered too.
On the day of our wedding, my love Eurydice stepped on the bed of the snake. In return, it stole away her best years. I cried. I cursed the high skies until I could not bear it. I dared down to descend into the shadows, through the infernal gates to the river Styx. And I went to Persephone, and they came to death. And I sang a song.
Binds me as it binds you.
as she stepped out from among the recent dead,
still limping from the wound on her ankle.
Edie's told us she could go with me on one condition, that I must not look back at her while we're still in the valleys of the underworld or the gift would be in vain. I agree. What else could I have done? As we climbed the path in mutual silence, it was thick and covered in a heavy fog, and I thought I lost her. I needed to see her. So I turned around, and there she was, grasping and hoping to be grasped. But an ill-favored wind snatched her away. And just like that, she was dying again for the second time. Yet, she had no complaint, no rebuke for her husband. For what could I complain of, except that I was in love?
Eurydice, hello, my love.
Trying to leave the underworld without me. Again?
Yeah, no, that's not what I'm doing at all.
Actually,
I turned down an offer from a mortising for Ovid.
You'll introduce me?
This is worse than you.
Now, what were you saying?
Our story, and some others.
The ones where you extolled the virtue and beauty of loving men?
I promise to love no other woman.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you don't mind, do you? If we're relevant. I have him for the rest of eternity now. And I knew what I was getting into when I married a love poet. He needed to sing about something other than my untimely death.
You need to sing? Even now, after what it caused?
I think you know the answer to that one.
It really is like love. A poet, maddened, keeps singing, even after it wounds them.
Let the record show that I did not beat him that long.
Orpheus?
Right. Well, we should be going. You know how wives are.
This is rude.
I hope you don't want me saying, but I don't want to be seeing you anytime soon.
Me neither.
Oh, come here, you two. Take care of each other.
You too.
Oh, you can keep the lyre. I don't have my plate anyways.
They're so cute and pushy.
I envy him, you know. No one will ever forget him. The greatest poet of all time. The voice to move stones.
Are you for real?
Excuse me?
I thought you knew. I thought you'd, in fact, heavily admired it. He's you. You're him. If poetry carries anyone's memory forward through centuries, it certainly carries yours.
As long as I'm read by the mouths of people, if the wisdom of the old poets has any fruit, I shall live.
Now he gets it. Good Lord, the effort it took to get you to remember the end of your own life.
Well, there hasn't really been anyone around to remind me. At least no one persistent enough to get it through my head.
I am an expert at getting people's heads. I didn't mean it that way.
Why all the effort, then?
Because I need you. Again, not you. Like that. What's love without poetry? Love to lose can't exist without someone to help them.
You. An absolutely, completely all-powerful god. Need me?
Ah, you're mocking forget? What if they forget?
I promise you that's not gonna happen. Not for like, it's like 2,000 years at least.
Well, I can't come here to God, can I?
Has that ever stopped you before?
You know me too well. I guess this is goodbye.
Get sappy on me, I'll cry. But remember, love's work is never done. I'll see you, Yama.
Wait. Can I ask one more thing?
No.
Please, I need to know. Rome! Do I ever get to go home again?
Soft may the bones of Ovid lie.